Hey, what's going on, everyone? And today we are talking about how to best set up your GoPro Hero 6 for taking photos. When I turn on my GoPro Hero 6, I start in the default mode, which is the movie mode. So I have to click on the video icon in the lower left and then switch over to photo mode. Now at the bottom of the screen, we can see that essentially we have only one setting available, which is the field of view. And here we have two options available. First, wide, and second, linear mode. Wide is the default, which is a fairly large field of view with a bit of a fisheye effect around the edges. Now linear is a mid-range field of view, but still rather wide, and here the GoPro applies in-camera lens correction, eliminating that barrel distortion or fisheye effect, which I prefer for now, so let's go with linear, but we'll go back to wide again in just a second. Now it would be silly to expect that this is the only thing that I would want to show you. So let's swipe left to have a look at the ProTune settings, the advanced settings for shooting photos. Shutter speed I usually keep at auto and let the camera decide what's the best shutter speed for the current lighting condition. Exposure compensation allows for manual correction over the auto exposure. So in harsh lighting conditions, if your image is too dark or too light, you can dial it in. I keep that at zero for now. Next, we set the minimum and maximum ISO. Usually I keep the minimum ISO at 100, but I adjust the maximum ISO value. The higher the ISO, the more sensitive the sensor gets to light. But with higher sensitivity, we introduce also more noise to the image. Which means setting the ISO is always a balancing act between low light capabilities of your camera versus how much noise you are willing to accept in your image. I prefer a rather clean image, so I set the maximum ISO to 1600. White balance I keep at auto, unless the color is absolutely off, which sometimes happens at night. At these situations, I dial in the white balance manually. By default, sharpness is set to high, which in my opinion is too sharp. It makes the image look almost unnatural. I prefer to dial it down and set sharpness to medium. When shooting video, I choose the color profile native because it makes it easier for me to color grade the footage in post. For shooting photos, however, especially when I want to use the photos right out of the camera for social media, I go with GoPro. So this is how I set up the camera for shooting photos, but only if I want to use the photos right away out of the camera for social media, for example, without much further processing. If you don't shy away, however, to use an application like, for instance, Photoshop or Lightroom to edit your photos properly, there is a much better way to shoot photos with the GoPro Hero 6. If you swipe left, you can turn on shooting RAW. Now, what is RAW? Every time you take a photo with your GoPro Hero 6, essentially what the camera does is take a full sensor readout and then processes an image based on your settings. So the GoPro applies white balance, color profile, sharpness, contrast, saturation, and once the image is processed, every data that the GoPro doesn't need anymore, it just gets rid of it. So afterwards, if you want to make some significant changes, all that data is gone, which makes it much harder to do so. If you turn on RAW, however, that full sensor readout gets saved as a separate file to your SD card. So if you're using a program, like for instance Adobe Lightroom, you can process that readout yourself. So adjust the white balance, the colors, the saturation, the sharpness, and since all the data is still there, you can really create that image that you want. But as you can see, shooting in RAW is only available with wide field of view. So we have to go back, go to the field of view settings, and change it from linear back to wide. And after we have done that, we can now turn on shooting in RAW, which means the GoPro will save a separate RAW file alongside your JPEG file. And I'll show you now how to quickly process that RAW file in Adobe Lightroom. The RAW file has the ending GPR, and you'll find it right next to the JPEG file on your SD card. Just drag it to your hard drive, and then let's open it in Lightroom and start developing the photo. First, we bring down the highlights and then open up the shadows in order to bring back all the information in the lighter and darker areas of our photo. Then we set the white point by holding down the Alt key and then we drag the white slider to the right just so nothing from the image comes through. Normally I would do the same with the black points, but since we have already enough contrast, I will just slightly bring down the blacks. Overall, I think the image is slightly too dark. So as a next step, we bring up the exposure to around 0.5. And now to the fun stuff, let's increase the clarity, then the vibrance, and then bring up saturation. So this looks already very good. As a next step, we increase sharpening. In here, try not to go over 70, otherwise your image looks unnatural. Since we don't want to apply sharpening to the smoother areas of our photo, we keep holding down the Alt key and drag the masking slider to the right until nothing of the clouds, for instance, or the sky is coming through. Then to add noise reduction, let's drag the luminance slider to the right, but let's not go over 50, otherwise we'll lose too much detail. And then as a final step, let's remove chromatic aberration. And obviously, you could do much more with this photo, but I just wanted to demonstrate a quick and easy edit. And this would be our final result. This is the edited RAW file. This is how the JPEG looks like. And now back to the RAW file. So this is it, guys. This is how to best set up your GoPro Hero 6 for photography. And I hope you enjoyed this little video. If you did, please like and subscribe. If you have any questions or feedback, as always, just leave a comment down below. And with that, I catch you guys in my next video.